We see a very robust execution of our business. We started the year by guiding sales growth of 3-6%. And despite COVID-19, we are maintaining that guidance. So that is a sign that we have a strong uptake of our brands. We're taking market shares. And the COVID-19 impact is really a reversal in Q2 of the stocking impact we saw in Q1 and less patients seeking new treatment going to the physicians. But we also see a gradual normalization of that. We can see that patients are now again seeking a new treatment. So we are optimistic that we can go through this COVID-19 pandemic in a relative solid way.
In terms of the patients who are seeking new treatments now after the lull in treatments during the heart of the pandemic and the lockdowns around the world, how is the geographic split? Are you seeing that across the different geographies, or are certain parts of the world seeing a bigger trend toward patients returning than others?
It's clear there is a strong link to the underlying societal impact of COVID-19. So the countries where, the outbreak has been controlled the best and lockdowns are opening, obviously there's a stronger flow and our commercial activities are more directly related to the physicians. But across the board, we see that societies are finding ways to handle COVID-19 in a way that we now have a big share of our reps back promoting our products. In the US, we have close to all reps in the field, not having the full access they had before, but all reps are in the field. In the rest of the world, we are around, say, 60% of medical representatives who are out pushing our products. So we see that in all countries, we are finding ways to keep our business running, keeping manufacturing running on all factories, and now also gradually returning to the normal commercial activities.
How has COVID-19 affected enrollment in your drug trials? You talked about patients returning for treatment and how that's affecting your business, but what about the drugs that you're currently testing?
We have been lucky in the fact that some of our major late-stage trials had already recruited patients and were close to reporting out. So we see no delay in our important late-stage pipeline assets. We have seen that for some of the earlier trials that are recruiting, that has been at a lower rate than we saw, but that is now also gradually picking up. So we are at, a 40% recruitment of patients compared to where we were, and that's gradually improving week by week.